Hi, I'm Lizanne Hamilton Smith, or Nee as Irving, when I became here in 1990 to the Eastern College of Nursing to start my student training. So I am an original GRI nurse. It's only GRI nurses can call themselves a real nurse. I became here when I was 17, and the reason I came to the Royal was I had the four options from my parents that I could get into art school, primary school teaching, or degree nursing. But if I came to the Royal, I stayed in the nurse's home, I could stay here for £50 a month and get paid £330. So it was a no-brainer that I could leave home at 17 and get a wage and stay somewhere for £50 a month. So that's why I ended up in the Royal at 17. I took 3 years to do my training, where the Royal provides fantastic variances of all different options. Your training was modular training at that point, and you could do 18 months, and then some we split from our mental health colleagues from that point. But from the Royal, obviously, it serves a large population. So we got to experience Gatlock, Easter House, all these different population or the experience of the Glasgow banter, shall we say. So, and nothing makes Glasgow than the people and what they can offer all our patients to us. During my training at the Royal, I've been in theatres, different places, but my majority was in the renal unit. I've been to ITU and things like that as well. Fond memories of patients and all the people around here. A great community, but not even that. A great for firsts within the renal unit and within the Royal. People have been quite innovative and creative with different projects. And one of them, probably was the latter part of, was the advanced nurse practitioners. We were the first advanced nurse practitioners in Glasgow. And this was when European directive came in and was changing the roles. And we were the forefront of that. And I was in the renal unit as a grade E at the point and used to do all crazy shifts, 2 in the afternoon to 3 in the morning, to accommodate our patients, because our renal patients worked as well. So they would work all day and then come in at night and dialyse. So we would stay to 3 in the morning, then go home and then come back out at 7 or 8 in the morning to do the shift all over again. But when I was an E grade, I was able to transfer up to being a G grade as an ANP. And from that, there was only a couple of us within the Royal when we got together, because it was a new training programme. Academia hadn't got caught up with what the ANP, or in fact, we were called case managers. And being in the Royal, the case managers, we had to scout the sub basements and the sixth floor for for desks, and we didn't have a uniform. It's a brand new role, but it was great. And because of the networking in the Royal, it was such a community, people did embrace the new role and supported us while we were finding our feet and what we had to do and what not to do, and became the chairperson for the ANPs at that time. And it was a great service. But quite a lot of the funnier things is, because we were such a community, and especially in our student nurses days, we used to actually run from our nursing home through the chicken run, as in the old, probably now beautiful conservatory, and run underneath the basement to the Manx Bar. And we'd used to maybe take an empty bottle of diluting juice, fill it up with whatever aperitif we'd like, and then in our pyjamas, run through the underneath casualty and run back to the nurse's home. We used to go to the Manx or the Lee or the Lord Todd. That was the days you used to be able to go out for £5 and then go to the get shots and then go to the disco and come back and get, we used to say, like a rolling egg out the Chucky van that used to be outside the Royal, the A&E, and that would be like your snack for your night so that you could wake up the next day without your hangover. Obviously the Royal's seen such a lot of changes, and where I used to stay actually became one of the consultant nephrologists, the offices. I nearly died when I went in one day, and I was like, that was my bedroom, and he's like, oh my goodness, like what's going on in here? And I'm like, oh no, that type of thing. And I've actually left the Royal at NHS 5 years ago, but I'm actually just about to come back in. I left to become a lecturer, and I've came back in. But from just to the story was that when I came in, my first placement was Ward 2, and my staff nurse, who was my mentor at that point, is actually now my line manager 30 years later. So it's came full circle. So the Royal I love the character of the building. I love how you're able to open the windows. You feel as though you actually can have fresh air. It's got such history to it, even connection to the cathedral and, you know, St Mungo's and obviously the John Knox Cemetery. But it's been great fun. Loved all the people. I was really disheartened like that when part of redesign was moved to the western end to the Queen Elizabeth. But I suppose sometimes there's change that has to be for change. But we've still got awful fond memories of the Royal.